Mexican street corn is the ultimate summertime snack, but if you've tried one elote recipe, you've pretty much tried them all. So that got me thinking, what if there was a way to make a brand new version of Mexican street corn using Japanese ingredients that is different from any other elote you've ever had before? What makes a traditional street corn so delicious is that it manages to hit all five basic tastes at one time. Sweetness from corn, savoriness from mayonnaise, saltiness from cotija cheese, sour, and a little bitterness from lime. And because elote is such a perfectly balanced dish, there's no reason to stray from that underlying flavor profile. So we're gonna sub in some really unique Japanese ingredients that manage to hit all of these same notes while also bringing out a whole new kaleidoscope of interesting flavors. Now, for the mayo component, we lucked out because the greatest mayonnaise on earth is from Japan, Kewpie. If you've never heard of it, it's a mayonnaise that is made with only egg yolks instead of the whole egg, which gives it a super smooth, almost custardy consistency. It's also made with apple cider and rice vinegar, which makes it a bit tangier than its Western counterparts. And it has a bit of MSG, which gives it an incredible depth of flavor. If you've never tried Kewpie, you're really missing out. There's a reason why chefs around the world swear by it. For the citrus and hot sauce flavor, I want to introduce you to a really interesting Japanese condiment called yuzu kosho. It's essentially a fermented blend of the yuzu citrus fruit, ground chili peppers, and salt. It's got a funky, citrusy, mildly spicy flavor. It basically tastes like a really intense citrus-flavored salsa. That's the best way I can describe it. You wouldn't necessarily dip a chip in it because it's super concentrated, but when you add it to another dish, it's a great way to introduce a really unique, spicy, salty, citrus note that doesn't overpower but elevates other flavors. We're gonna add this to our Kewpie to make a yuzu kosho mayonnaise. And let me just state for the record, despite my background in fine dining, I categorically refuse to call this a yuzu kosho aioli because that's just annoying, such as my devotion to principle. For the cheese, we're sticking with cotija because there really isn't a better Japanese alternative, and it is elote after all. But if you're having trouble finding cotija, Parmesan or feta also work really well. You're basically just looking for a salty, crumbly cheese. And also, this is one of the few times I would actually recommend buying the pre-grated version over the block cheese, and that's just because they're able to grate it much finer than you can at home, and it just sticks to the corn in a more visually appealing way. For the chili powder, the most common variety you'll see used in traditional elote is tajin, which is a blend of ground chili peppers, lime, and salt. And there is a perfect Japanese substitution called shichimi togarashi. This is essentially a blend of seven spices. In fact, in the West, you'll most often find it labeled as Japanese seven spice. The blend of spices varies depending on the brand, but all of them have ground chili pepper and a citrus element, which makes it perfect for our Japanese elote. And finally, to garnish, I like to add a bit of finely shaved katsuobushi. This is salted and smoked bonito fish, and it's an essential element of Japanese cuisine. If you've ever had miso soup, this is one of the two ingredients in the dashi broth. Bonito has a sort of smoky, oceanic flavor that is distinctively Japanese. It kind of tastes like bacon from the sea, very, very rich in umami. And an interesting aside, if you add bonito flakes to a warm dish, they sort of dance in the heat like they're alive, which is kind of cool for presentation. Now, when you buy elotes, 9 times out of 10, it's made with boiled corn. And the easiest way to do this at home is to bring 4 quarts of water up to a boil, kill the heat, toss in your cobs, put on a lid, and leave it for 20 to 30 minutes. And that's it. Super easy and perfectly boiled corn every time. But I'm actually partial to the flavor of grilled corn for my elote, which is perfect because there is a very popular version of grilled corn from Japan called yaki tomorokoshi. Essentially, what you'll do is just grill your corn as usual, and while it's cooking, brush it with a glaze made of equal parts melted butter, soy sauce, and mirin. The butter is a classic combo, the soy adds the salty component and a bit of umami, and the mirin enhances the natural sweetness of the corn. Perfect for the foundation of our next level elote. But more often than not, when I'm at home, I don't feel like starting a fire just to make corn. So this is how I recreate yaki tomorokoshi without having to go outdoors. I'll just take my cobs and toss them in the microwave while they're still in the husks. The general rule of thumb is 4 minutes for one cob and to add 2 minutes for each additional corn. Then when they're done, cut off the bottom, grab the top, and shake out the corn just like this. They should slide right out with very few of those distracting silk strands attached. After microwaving, I'll melt some butter in a pan and saute the corn until it gets a bit of color. Then in the last few minutes of cooking, I'll brush the cobs with equal parts soy sauce and mirin. And while it might lack a bit of the smoky flavor from the fire, I find this method much less labor intensive, and the taste is virtually identical to grilling. Now, for the yuzu kosho mayonnaise, let's add half a cup of Kewpie mayonnaise to a bowl, and to that, add 1 tablespoon of yuzu kosho. Stir until it's well combined and give it a taste. If it's too citrusy and spicy, add a little bit more mayo. And if it's too bland, add more yuzu kosho. Now take the corn and add a wooden skewer to each cob. And a pro tip, doing this with cooked corn is much easier than trying to do it with raw corn. Then spread a thin layer of yuzu kosho mayo on the cob. Now take a bowl filled with grated cotija and spoon it over the corn until it is totally covered. Sprinkle on a bit of the togarashi chili peppers and finish with a garnish of our shaved bonito flakes. And that's it. Now let's give it a try. All right, really quick before our taste test, I just want to say that I generally find fusion food pretty cringe. However, since we use Japanese ingredients that stay true to the original flavor profile of Mexican street corn, I want you to think of this less as fusion food and more as an homage to one of the great street foods of the world. All right, back to the taste test. The taste is very familiar yet very different at the same time. You're really staying true flavor-wise to everything that makes a traditional elote great, but you're really bringing something unique to the table. The Kewpie adds a little bit more richness. You got the salty, spicy, citrusy thing going on with the yuzu kosho, the toasty spiciness of the togarashi, and the oceanic smokiness from the katsuobushi. Now, I love Mexican street corn, and we ate it a lot growing up in Texas, but this version is definitely worth trying. I used to work in an izakaya, which is sort of like a Japanese pub, and we sold hundreds of these every night. It was one of our most popular dishes. And if you decide to make this at home, this would be perfect as a really unique side dish for a barbecue, or even just as a really quick weeknight snack. And I want to give you one last pro tip. If you find yourself with a ton of leftover corn like I did from making this video, this is what you do. Take each cob and shave off the kernels just like this. Then mix them with the yuzu kosho mayonnaise we made earlier, garnish with a bit of cheese, togarashi chili peppers, and a bit of the shredded bonito. Now you've just made Japanese esquites. And if you liked this video, you might like this one too. Thanks for watching.